When it comes to getting started with investing, there's no time like the present. If you're in your 20s, time is your biggest asset. It's hard to overstate how valuable your time is in your 20s. But on the long road to retirement, saving throughout the decade is kind of like putting an extra engine in your car. It is in your 20s that you begin to understand the real importance of saving, investment, and returns. This is the age when you start to have financial freedom and you slowly start taking responsibility for your own life. So the financial decisions you make in your 20s are arguably more important than any other time in your life. For investing, the most important factor is compounding. The magic of compounding allows investors to generate wealth over time and requires only two things: the reinvestment of earnings and time. So the sooner you start, the sooner you can obtain your financial goals. Now, if you have savings in hand, what's the best way to invest and where? Deciding how to invest money in your 20s can seem overwhelming at first. People have differing opinions, and it's really hard to figure out where to start. There's no particular rule that suits all investment strategies for an amateur investor. While there is no official playbook to follow, keeping some rules in mind can help with preparing your portfolio for long-term success. In this video today, we have come up with 7 such rules to invest in your 20s in the best way possible. So, let's get started. Number 1. Set your investment goals. Before investing, it's important to understand what you want to do with the wealth you create. It's ultimately looking at all the experiences you want to have over your lifetime and then prioritizing those things in accordance with how much they cost you. Setting investment goals is crafting the investment plan to make sure that those targets are achievable. For example, the money you save for a down payment on your first home is earmarked for a different goal than the retirement savings you won't touch for 40 or more years. When you are thinking about goals, you have to ask 2 questions to yourself. What is your goal for this money, and when will you want to use it? If you have savings that are not currently allocated for a specific financial goal, take some time to think about what goal you'd like to apply it to. A great first saving goal is to have 3 to 6 months of living expenses in an emergency fund. Once you've begun contributing to an emergency fund, start thinking about the goals you want to work towards by investing. Once you've outlined a set of goals and established a plan, you're ready to look into specific accounts. Number 2. Keep short-term savings somewhere easily accessible. Just like your emergency fund, which you need to access at a moment's notice, store your short-term investments somewhere easily accessible that are not subject to market fluctuations. Savings for short-term goals of less than 5 years should be kept in cash rather than investing them in the stock market. Market volatility is inevitable. It's the cost of higher expected returns in stocks versus bonds or cash, so it's definitely unwise to accept the risk of the market losses for your short-term goals because they have less time to recover. While they won't earn as much money you put into equities, high-yield savings accounts, CDs, and money markets accounts are great options. You might be giving up some potential growth, but it's more important to have the return of your money instead of a return on your money. Number 3. Incrementally raise your savings rate. Starting where you are is just fine. And if that means contributing just $100 or less a month, at least you're putting away something. But a general investing tip is that over time, you need to save more. One of the easiest ways to do that is to up your savings rate every time you get a raise. While savings for short-term goals should be in cash, a mix of stocks and bonds are essential to growing your wealth to fund the long-term goals like retirement. Committing to a specific savings rate and continuing to increase that year after year is what's going to have the biggest impact early in your savings career to get you started. Number 4. Make risk your friend and don't fear volatility. If you're just learning how to invest in your 20s, market volatility might scare you. But don't let it. Instead, take it as an opportunity. If you're investing for a long-term goal, one of the key rules to remember when you're investing in your 20s is that time is on your side. You have a larger window to allow your portfolio to recover from bouts of inevitable stock market volatility, which means you could choose to take more risk with your investments to achieve higher rewards. A portfolio that does not take enough risk will also require an unrealistic savings rate relative to your cash flow. Playing it too safe with your portfolio when you're younger might mean missing out on significant investment. Getting to know your risk tolerance can help you decide where and how to invest in your 20s to achieve your investment goals. Many investors make the mistake of avoiding risk even though it helps them over a long time frame. Reaching a million would require a reasonable allocation towards stocks. Of course, when you invest in a stock, you'll probably see drops in the short term. That's why the market is generally a no-go if you need the money within 5 to 10 years. But you'll come out ahead for the long-term financial goals such as retirement. Number 5. Diversify, but don't chase trends. While investing in your 20s, diversification is one of the most important concepts. Having a diversified portfolio that spans different asset classes can help towards your long-term goals. One big mistake to avoid as an investor in your 20s is holding concentrated positions in trendy investments. Stick with a diversified portfolio of low-cost funds invested in conventional asset classes, at least initially. This may sound boring, but steering clear of flashier investments while you get to know how the market works can be to your advantage. Investing is a complex activity, but that does not mean it requires a complex solution. The problem is that most investors get in their own way by unnecessarily meddling in their portfolios. There's an overwhelming amount of research showing that both individuals and professional investors routinely underperform the market, but that does not mean they should never invest. Instead, it simply suggests that a passive investment strategy will improve your chance for success. Number 6. Don't feel pressurized to go all in. Investing in your 20s means you have a lot of time on your side, so you don't need to rush. If you've never invested in the market before, you should ease into it. You'll need to get used to it before you feel comfortable with up and down swings of the market. For starters, invest in something you understand and worry about graduating to more complex investments later. But whichever route you choose, it's important to avoid getting bogged down in the details and losing perspective. The big picture is if you start investing now, you may be able to work a lot less over your life because you're letting your money do the heavy lifting over time. Number 7. Keep learning and be consistent. Learning how to invest money in your 20s does not happen overnight, and you may still be fuzzy in how certain parts of the market work. One thing to know about how to invest in your 20s is that consistency can pay off in the long run. Even if you're only able to invest a little money at a time, those amounts can add up as the years and decades pass. Continually educating yourself about different investments and investment strategies can give you the knowledge you need to guide your portfolio toward your financial goals. Now, before we end this video, I want to tell you something about the magic of compounding. Albert Einstein once described compound interest as the 8th wonder of the world. It's the phenomenon when the interest you earn on savings or investments builds on itself. Well, it's like a snowball effect. Since compound interest increases over time, young investors get a leg up on those who wait. Investing in your 20s is like running a race. Starting early gives you a competitive advantage, similar to a 10-second head start over fellow runners. Even when others join the race and begin investing later, they will have to work much harder just to catch up with you. Early investments lead to compounding returns. The time value of money increases over time. Not only will you ensure that your money keeps up with the inflation, but you'll also reap the benefits of decades worth of compound interest on your contributions. So if you are in your 20s, just remember that investing works best when it's done early in life. It will let your money grow, giving you more options in the future. Alright guys, those were the 7 best strategies you can incorporate in your life before you go about investing in your 20s. Thank you so much for watching the video. If you're in your 20s, let us know in the comments below how you are planning to become financially free. And if you're not in your 20s, let us know if you agree with all the strategies we've mentioned in the video. Please leave a thumbs up and share the video if you found it to be useful. For more content on investing and personal finance, click on our channel and don't forget to subscribe. See you guys in the next one.